Alright, today I've been avoiding it, but I'm going to do a review of this Meijer like pack they made for Magic the Gathering. I always see them sitting there, I just never feel like buying them, but I did a little side job, so I had a little bit of extra money and I decided to finally buy it. And if you're asking why I've never bought this before or reviewed it, it's because the sheer price of it, which I will show you now on my folder receipt. This thing cost $22.99. So you be the judge and think if it's worth it. I think it was like $24 with the tax. Let's just go over the outside first. It says contains one cellophane deck and two packs. Packs of Magic the Gathering. And it says plus bonus set of gaming dice and pack of card sleeves. And if you look at the top, you can see two decks, a Theros booster pack, and a Zendikar. So these have always been like sitting on the shelf, and I don't think they've ever gotten more because I think they are a tough sell. I think a better buy price would be around $15. You can see it comes with some sort of cellophane wrapped deck with instructions. I'm not sure. I think it's like from a starter deck, just without the pack. Some card sleeves. It might only be 50. I'm not sure. And if you look in the side, you can see some dice. And I'm gonna read this. It doesn't say who made this. I assume it's not by Magic. This collectible product in this package has been purchased directly from the manufacturer or purchased from secondary markets. So it means they just bought the cards from and everything from wherever. Could have been anywhere. Could have been in an alley. Could have been from Magic the Gathering themselves. And are repackaged for retail sales by MJ Holding Company, LLC. MJ Holding Company, LLC is not affiliated with the individual manufacturers of the trading card companies. Contained with this pack, all related trademarks and logos are trademarks of their respected owners. So they have nothing to do with Magic, otherwise they buy their products. It looks like they gave me a free booger. Ew, disgusting. Has some barcode on it. I do feel like it's a little pricey. That's why I've never bought it before, but I thought it was just something to do. So let's crack it open. So this has just been repackaged by a company. Obviously, companies don't go to business to lose money, so they're going to be trying to make money. So I'm sure that's what they're doing. That's why it's priced a little bit high. So let's just get this out of here. And I've seen ones in the past. Like, they had one in the back. It's been there so long. It has an M15 pack. And, I don't know, maybe a Theros. And it only contains these two. And now they added these as incentives, and it's the same price. And if you, see a red dice. I wonder if it's a spin down. We'll see. The dice look kind of cheap quality, but it's okay. Comes with a very solid, I believe, case. Actually, let me grab some sleeve cards real quick to see if they'll fit in there. We'll just grab a couple. Some of this, some of that, some of this. And yeah, that should be good. Just for some later tests to see if that can actually be used as a nice holder. Obviously, it fits packs. It looks quite tight of a fit, so it might not hold sleeved cards. But we'll see. I'm not sure how it opens. I assume these thumb tabs. And the stuff is way in there. Way packed in there. So, this is just like an acrylic case. There's no actual lock except the air friction itself. Kind of takes a minute to close. But, I guess if you want to, like, you could probably use this for anything. Like, put something cool in there, like some fossils, and display it. Like, I don't know. Like, I don't even know, not even for Magic. Can I just put some fossils in there? Like, this is like an old fossilized sand dollar and just some coral. Yeah, or I will be testing if it will fit cards now before we get to the other piles of stuff. Just kind of have it in the background, just relaxing. I'm going to try some Ultra Pro sleeves first. can tell by the glorious logo of covering. They are quite a tight fit. In fact, I can't even push them all the way into the bottom. It doesn't want to really do anything, but I guess you could put them in long ways. So that actually works. I wasn't thinking about that. So yeah, you can actually probably fit in many sleeves, but it actually doesn't close all the way. There's a little bit of a lip, if you can see right there, because the cards are thicker. Like the packs that were in here just barely fit in. So I think this is more for unsleeved cards. But I'm going to try just some others to see. Some Ultra Pro, some... What are these? These are some Dragon Shield. Dragon Shield shiny ones. I'm going to go ahead and throw these in here the long ways. And I assume again that... Well, it's a little bit of a snugger fit. That it might fit... A little bit hard to close. I'm worried about like crunching them because I wish it's what the sleeve one on the outer portion or something. It's a little scaring me, but it closes, and I wanted the cards to be all face sideways. Well, I guess they will fit if you lay them down, but I wanted them to test it in this orientation, so I might have to do some angling. And as you can tell, again, they want to go a little bit crooked because there's a slight gap. If you're there, all the way straight back. You see the slight gap? Yeah, and these are just Dragon Shield. The Dragon Shield non-mat. They are so slippery. There we go. And then the next thing I want to try is, I guess, double sleeve cards. And actually, I'm going to grab my land deck of just KMC Perfect Fits. Come here, land deck. I know you want to be tested. I believe the Perfect Fits... I don't know if you can hear me. I believe the Perfect Fits will do a much better job. But first, let's test out the Werewolf deck. And I have a feeling, I don't know why, that it will be the same as... the other ones. You can see there's a little bit of a lip. I'm sorry, I'm just trying to keep it flat. And you can see there is the slightest bit of gap. But one thing to note is if you do put your cards in like sideways, kind of trying not to get them to slide around. I want to close. It's catching on some of the bottoms and some of the tops of the cards. Ay. If you do put them in sideways, it will fit them, but there is some wiggle room, so maybe you'd have to throw some dice in there or something. But I wouldn't really put in a nice deck because it'll be just bashing around. Probably won't do damage. And it has kind of a weird closing mechanism, like it's caught on some of the cards and stuff. It's a little bit scary. Maybe always load it this way. Probably. Yeah, probably load the bottom compartment first. And let's try the KMC Perfect Fits. I feel like these have a good chance of fitting. If you can see, it pretty much, I think they'll fit perfectly fine. Yeah, definitely put in the bottom portion first. Oop, wrong way. And yeah, it fits perfectly fine. So if you want to... And my camera died while recording while I was saying... So it fits perfectly fine, the KMC Hypermat sleeves, because they're so small, about the same width as the pack, there's barely any extra border. So those you can just fill up in here and store them in here. Very cool. The next thing I'm going to try is just some unsleeved cards, which I'm sure will fit. I can get a hold of these slippery little devils. Uno momento. Come on, there we go. The side for now, and just a whole pile of land. I'm really not sure how many cards can fit in here. Maybe like if I would like put a piece of paper in here just to keep them up or something. Like I don't know, here's a piece of paper. Like this is what I do if there's not enough room. just to make them stay up. Yeah, but you can tell it can definitely fit a bunch of cards. Very cool. You can even put your decks in here, but there's really no lock. It is some pretty solid acrylic. There is some give to it, so I don't think it will fracture. But I don't know. It might fracture if you drop it. I'm not quite sure. I'm not sure if this is like Ultra Pro's brand or just some generic sports case. Oh, shoot. Moved the Z camera by mistake. And then let's go on to the other stuff of the package, which I will now go over. It comes with two booster packs. I got Battle for Zendikar and Theros. And it comes with how many dice? These dice, let's just go over the dice first. These dice feel very light, as in cheap plastic. Is this a spin down? Let me see. I don't think so. Find the 20. And they're not spin down dice. This one isn't. Is this one? No. So these are manufactured probably by the same company. This one is clear, if you can tell. A clear red 20 side dice. It's very nice for a new player. It gives you some dice and just four nice dice with the underlined sixes, and I'm sure the underlined nines. I mean, what am I talking about? This is a six-sided dice. So very cool. Comes with dice, but I'll compare them to just like some other dice I have, as in like these feel heavier and more like solid. I don't know, actually. They're alright, but I do like these better, and just because of the fact that they're spin down, so you can go like 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14. These ones you're gonna have to like go 20, then you have to search for whatever number, then 7, then look for a 3, and be like, where's the 3? Where's the 3? Boom. So you'll spend time searching with these, but it's really not that big of a deal. It's more like this dice. This is an older 20-sided dice I have, and it's not a spin down. So it's similar to this, but it feels like it's made of the same plastic as these. This just feels like a different plastic or resin, but it's not that bad. And these dice aren't that bad, actually. They're really not that bad. They're about the same. So it's cool. It comes with some dice, and then these are just some others I have. Yeah. Can never go wrong with dice. Oop, I put the other dice there. So really not that bad of dice. So this thing costs $22. It comes with two packs, some dice, some sleeve protectors. I assume this case is counted in because it's really not that bad of a thing. And you can also store like I showed, fossils or collectibles or anything like that. Or even magic cards. And I believe this is, there's a foil. I believe like this is Avacyn Crest Restored like starter deck with the, which they removed the booster and just like threw in the pack itself. I'm really not sure what's in here, but I'll be loving to crack it open and show you. Maybe there'll be some cool cards. I wish it was a black deck, but maybe it's like blue and black. I really don't know. I haven't bought a starter. Mashing the camera. I haven't really bought a starter deck in quite a while. It looks like it comes with like the rule book or something, or maybe like the color chart. I'll open them up in a second. Just put away the utensil. So let's just move these a little bit to the side. Kind of keep them all in frame. Yeah, put some dice by it or something. So this is this like, what is this? This is a very long poster. One second, let me just try not to rip it with all the creases. Oh my. Oh, it's a very nice mechanic. This is the best player's guide I've seen than those like little cards. It talks about like tapping and lands and casting spells and turn order and parts of the magic card. I really like the parts of the magic card, like the mana cost, power and toughness, abilities, type tells you what creature it is. I really like this poster, actually. It's a little bulky, but that's alright. It's good for bigger eyes. I mean, bad eyes. And it shows you how to attack and how damage is dealt. Very cool. I actually like this. I appreciate this. I feel like they should give these out in deck builders toolkits and that Shadows of Innistrad deck kit I booster battle pack I reviewed. I'll just set that in the background a little bit. Can't really tell what it is, but that's okay. Yeah, and this thing, it's if you can't really pick it up that well unless you go from the bottom. It's such a flat edge. If you don't get a good grip on a flat surface, it's kind of hard to pick up. I wish it had some clasp, but really, it's kind of a nice plastic box. I don't know if I use it for magic cards or maybe just put in something really cool that I like, but still. And this is this the color sheet? Yes, I've seen this one and I'm not sure what. These are always nice too, but this poster in the background is quite detailed and quite nice. I like that. That's very good for a new player. And this just kind of tells you what each color does. White is a color for law and order structure and stuff like protection, order, plans. Blue is detect intelligence and black is death and decay. Red is fury and chaos. Green is life and nature. Interesting. I think I saw on the other one it said emotion on her. I thought that was funny. Yeah, but this is nice, but really this poster is where it's at. It even tells you about card types and I think this is a great thing. And it has a glossary of all the terms death touch, defender, discard, double strike. This is really nice. I mean, the terms are always getting updated. Flying, flash, hexproof, vigilance, indestructibility, hexproof. Even though the terms are always getting updated, this is from the Avacyn Restored, so it probably won't have some of them. So I'll put the poster I at least like behind it, or info sheet. I really do like that info sheet, so that's quite nice, but it is just an info sheet, and I guess it's cool. I've never got one of these starter decks. Well, I mean, when I was a kid, but they were different, and they came in just little boxes. Very interesting. So I got a foil rare Lone Revenant 3 and 2 blue creature spirit. Hexproof. This creature can't be the target of spell or ability your opponent controls. Whenever Lone Revenant deals combat damage to a player, if you control no other creatures, look at the top four cards of your library, put one of them into your hand and the rest on the bottom of your library. So it's not even a creature card. You can just look at your creature cards. It's a 4/4 foil. Surprisingly, I got a different rare. A black rare, so this is actually might be a cool deck. Black and blue, I like it. I'm only gonna read the rares and maybe the uncommons. Demonic Rising, 3 and 2 black. Let me just angle this down just a teeny bit. And it's enchantment. At the beginning of your end step, if you control exactly one creature, put a 5/5 black demon creature token with flying onto the battlefield. Very interesting. So you can have this out as extra protection in case you have one creature, but it only works if you have one creature. And so it only get one dragon, and then I guess if you let the other creature die and the dragon was out, you get another dragon. Something like that. Very cool. So I got two rares I know of, and I'm going to just do a quick common and uncommon sort. It might have all the uncommons and commons up front. And I'll just quickly scroll through them. Bunch of cards. And it's got a mix of sets in here too. Some, of course, lands, I forgot. A lot of lands. It's funny, the lands were just kind of in the middle. But it comes with, I'm not sure how many lands. Zombie Horror. Bat Skeleton. Oh man, I wanted this guy. He's going in my skeleton deck. Sorry, I just got excited. These are uncommon. So, I am pretty excited. It has some cool black cards. Got some zombies, some spirits, human rogues, some corpse traders. Oh, they reprinted that. Some zombies, wizards. I have zombie wizard decks, skeleton decks, so this is really nice. Flip through the commons. I'm not going to read them off. There's quite a many. It looks like they give you maybe like two of these, three of these. So they give you probably a better deck. Probably nice. Some birds, some demons. Sorry, I don't think I got the power and toughness in there for a minute. Interesting art. Instant, what is that, like, robot or an Eldrazi? I don't know. Doomblade, I thought these were uncommon. Who knows? Maybe they keep changing it, like Sarah Angel. Crippling Chill. It reminds me of that movie where those people fell into, like, a hole in the ice, and then they try to get rescued. Very interesting. That's when I learned if you inject air into your veins, you would have a heart attack. Interesting fact. And I'll just go ahead and read the uncommons, because why not? I might have... Yeah, like I thought, there's probably some doubles. Alright. The first uncommon I got is a... Fettergeist. He's all chained up, and it looks like... I don't know if the humans are following him, or... He's following the humans. He's two and a blue. Create speech or flying at the beginning of your upkeep. Sacrifice Fettergeist unless you pay one for each other creature you control. If he's out by himself, you don't have to pay. But if you have a bunch of other creatures out, he might get sacked. And he's a 3/4. And I have two of those. I got a Corpse Trader. I actually pulled one of these in the new set. Very cool. Same art. It's like doctors back in the day. When dead people died, they try to get him and learn about the internals. Corpse Traders, 3 and a black. Creature, human, rogue, uncommon. It is a 3/3 creature, 2 and a black. Sacrifice creature, target opponent reveals his or her hand. Choose a card from it. That player discards that card. Activate this ability only anytime you cast a sorcery. Very cool. I got Marrow Bats, awesome. Some skeletons with flying. Awesome. I like that. It's 4 and a black. Probably gonna put these in my skeleton deck. Flying. Pay 4 life. Regenerate bone. Marrow bat. So if you need to, it's quite a high cost. But in a dire moment, you might need to. And it's a 4/1. And it's a flying. Very cool. I wonder how they're flying with their wings all broken. And I got two of those. It's just very exciting. I got a Swiftfoot boot. It looks like one of his boots is on fire. I don't know, for some reason I'm thinking that SpongeBob Boots episode. Silly me. Two colorless artifact equipment. This is from M12. Equipped creature has hexproof and haste. It can't be the target of spells or abilities your opponent controls, and it can attack and tap as soon as it comes into play under your control. Equipped is one, and attached target creature you control equipped only as a sorcery. So, give your creature hexproof and haste. Very cool. I got a Tormentor's Trident. Looks like that one sea god, except like devilish. Two colorless artifact equipment. Equipped creature gets +3 and attacks each turn if able, 3. So you could either play this on a creature you have or a creature your opponent has that you want to kill. So make him attack. Like that option, I got two of those. I got another enchantment, Triumph of Cruelty. Looks like, Liliana is sending some, like, skeletons or werewolves upon this poor man. It is a 2 and a black enchantment. At the beginning of your upkeep, target opponents discard a card. If you control a creature with powers, with greatest power or tied for greatest power. So pretty much if you have a bigger creature, it makes them discard a card. Or if it's tied. Very cool. I got Into the Void. I've seen this in a reprinting, I believe. Very cool picture. It's like some tornado vortex black hole thing going on. And they get sucked in. 3 and a blue. Sorcery. Return up to 2 target creatures to their owner's hand. Cool. And I got 2 of those. And the last uncommon is a homicidal seclusion. They look withered and they look depressed and sad just looking out the window. But I gotta say, this art is real nice. 4 and a black enchantment. As long as you control exactly one creature, that creature gets +3/+1 and has lifelink. So it's like kind of like disenchantment, all about one creature. So very cool. Cool. So those are, I got two rares, some uncommons and commons, and a bunch of land. Let's just count how many land. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 13 swamps, and I'm assuming 13 islands. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And 11 islands. Nope, that's because there's probably more black cards in the mana curve. So I'll just, I guess, put these kind of in frame over here somewhat. And then I'm going to open the packs last, and now I'm going to go over the deck protectors. Let's check these out. I guess just like put these back there in the right order. Lands. Real excited about those skeleton bats. Some rares. So these are actually a brand name, Ultra Pro. I thought for sure it was going to be like something. And it isn't only 50 sleeves. I don't get why they don't sell them in 60. Well, maybe for like other games or like draft, or I know like sealed sometimes they do like 40 cards. But I would just like them to bump it up, because they really just want you to spend a little bit extra money. I'm not sure how much these cost, so I don't know how much this adds into the value. Probably a dollar or two. And these packs are probably around like $3 each or something, or four, I don't know. And this deck, I don't know how much it's worth. I really, really like that poster though. That is great information. So I'm going to go ahead and open these up and see what quality. It says, has a bunch of languages on it, so I assume they probably got them from like a different country. No PVC, highest clarity, stores and protects collectible cards, 50 sleeves, high quality type. They gotta let you know it's high quality. Ultra Pro deck protectors. And on the back, I wish I could read what this says. Like, what, I don't know, maybe it just says this on the back, but it looks like more info. Made in China. It's a shame. I wish it was in America. Or wherever Ultra Pro headquarters is located. That's how I think a business should run. Alright, let's open these up. And I'm not sure if they're all the same. They have a clear white back. I mean, so you slip the card in, I believe. And they're just Ultra Pro sleeves. With this very interesting dragon on it. Or dragon. So if you're actually want like a dragon deck, this might be great for you. And I'm not sure what that is. It's probably the artist, I assume. Cool. So I will do a little test. First though, I don't know what this is, but there's nothing. It's just like some junk. I'll just like throw in some cards, see how they fit. And I'll throw in some cards into other ones. This is just like another Ultra Pro. I don't know why I have so many jumps out. Oh yeah, I was going to do a video on it. This is like a generic penny sleeve. I'm not sure who made this. And then I'm going to try a perfect fit, KMC perfect fit. Grab one of them. For some reason, I really like the perfect fits. They just feel nice. And then I'll also Dragon Shield sleeve from the box. White mat. And the box for Dragon Shield sleeve, you can actually hold the sleeve cards in, which is great, like unlike the deck boxes you get in the Wizards products. And there we go. This is this one has the Ultra Pro logo on there. I like it better when it's at the corner. You don't see it as much. This is, I believe, a lot older. You can see it's all scratched up. This is a pretty nice finish. I wonder how long it would last. So this is, it looks like this one might be a little bit taller. Yeah, it is a little bit taller, so I do like that, because I always have a problem with these older ones. My cards just stick out a tiny bit. So this is the pack one versus a regular Ultra Pro, an old one or something. This is just like a penny sleeve from whatever. Yeah, it's nice. I definitely like it more than the penny sleeve because there's like wiggle room. This one's really not that much like that I care. This is the Dragon Shield mat. I like mat a little bit better because it's a little friction and sometimes I get sweaty hands. And Dragon Shields are just lovely. I wonder if they're about the same size. Dragon Shields still are a tiny bit taller, but still these are nice. And then let's go to the KMC Perfect Fit. KMC Perfect Fit's always a very tight fit. You can tell it's smaller and skinnier. That's why it fits in this plastic storage case easily. And then I'm going to compare it to a top loader. Very nice. I've never really played with top loaders. I feel like they'd be too bulky. But yeah, these are overall nice sleeves. And then I'm going to try to rip one and see how well it fares against these ones. That's a KMC Perfect Fit. Oh yeah, now I know I have all the jumps out. I wanted to do a video on how to tell the difference between editions, so I'm just looking for cards, some older cards that I have that will fit the criteria. And I'm still looking, so that's something to look forward to. And then the actual card sleeve that I received. Why am I replacing the sleeves with jumps? I don't know. So, first I guess we'll just go Ultra Pro. I'll rip the old Ultra Pro to see how much it survives. And it took a little bit, but then it just like snapped instantly. And then I'll rip this one last. Just put that one out. This is a KMC Perfect Fit. Let's actually rip the generic penny sleeve. I'm not sure what brand this is. Could be Ultra Pro, could be not. It's actually harder to rip, and the bottom didn't feel like splitting, but it's still split. Now, the KMC Perfect Fit. I really like these sleeves for some reason. And the bottom didn't split. It actually ripped at my fingers, and I hit my cabinet thing. And then the Dragon Shield Hyper Mat. These are usually good. Wow, not impressed. Is that just a bad one? Let me try one more. I remember seeing a video of maybe their quality went down or something. But I hope not. Because these, I have some that I pulled so hard and they just, they're definitely a lot harder to break. But sadly, they still do break. And then now, the ones that came with it. And yeah, it just pretty much snapped in half easily. So I'm not sure if it will split on you. There we go, just broke some sleeves for you. Now I only have 49. But it's okay, I would need to buy another one to even sleeve my decks. But still, it comes with some sleeves on the sides. There's like a bunch of gook. It looks like probably from when they heated and closed it, it was like a dirty thing with just a bunch of melted plastic on it that left marks. I'm assuming it's on this side too. And yeah, but these are nice. I like the white background instead of just like a black background. And can't see through it at all. Very cool. Nice pictures. So it comes with some 50 Ultra Pro sleeves. Very cool. And then now, let's open the booster packs. I guess I'll open Zendikar first. Maybe I'll hit that expedition that I... Sorry, these posters are just bugging me a little. Maybe I'll hit that expedition that I've always been looking for. And the myth might be broken. But in reality, chances are quite low. And I would only really want a Gideon. Just, I don't really care for this set. It's alright. Yeah, but yeah, it's better than the Oath of the Gatewatch, I think. A Run Reef Invoker, one and a green. Human Shaman, 8 generic mana. A Run Reef Invoker gets +5/+5 and gains trample until end of turn. It's a 2/2. So you can play it out early, and then if it stays alive for a while, you can use that, or you can play it later in the game and use that right away. Very cool. Put this in the common pile. Brilliant Spectrum, 3 and blue, Looks like he got some sort of orbs around his head and hands. Very cool. Sorcery, converge, draw X cards, with X is the number of color meant to spend, brilliant spectrum, then discard two cards. So max you can draw four cards if you spend like a red, black, yellow, and blue mana, different types. I don't really care for converge cards unless you're playing like, unless it was like my sliver deck or something which got all colors. I got a vampire, I got a Necron Assassin. Just sitting in the caves waiting for someone lonely to walk in and not get him, I guess. I don't know. Two and a black creature vampire assassin ally. Whenever you gain life, Narcan Assassin gains death touch until end of turn. Any amount of damage it deals to a creature is enough to destroy it. It's a 2/3. So somehow if you gain some life, he gets death touch. Very cool. I got a Seek the Wild, a 1 and a green. Look at the top 4 cards of your library. You may reveal a creature card or land from among them, put it into your hand, and put the rest on the bottom of your library in any order. Cool. I got a Kozyx Sentinel. Very interesting. Looks almost insect-like. Like beetle heads, multiple hands. Interesting. 1 and a red, a Drowsy Drone, Devoid. Whenever you cast a color spell, Kozyx Sentinels gets +1/+0 until end of turn, and it's a 1/4. Cliffside Lookout. 1 white, Core Scout Ally. It's a 1/1 creature. 4 and a white creatures you control get +1/+1. So if you want to pay 8, they could all get +2/+2. But it'll be 8 and 2, 6 and 2 white. So it's a lot, but interesting. Touch of the Void. Uh-oh, is he going to get a disease? Well, his hand looks like it's festering up or something real bad. No good. Run away. 2 and a red. Sorcery to Void. This card has no color. Touch of Void deals 3 damage to target creature or player. If a creature dealt damage this way would die, exile it. This turn, exile it instead. So if it kills a creature, you get to exile it as well. Maybe as a finisher or not. Well, it is a sorcery. I got a Sheer Drop. Looks like the Chlor Climber took a fall. 2 and a white. Sorcery, draw, destroy, target, tapped creature, and has awakening cost for 5 and a white. If you cast a spell for its awakening cost, 5 and a white. Also put 3+1/+1 counters on target land you control. It becomes a 0/0 elemental creature with haste, and it's still land. So it becomes a 3/3 land creature with haste that, if you want, can attack right away. And it stays a creature / land, so you can tap it for mana or attack with it, or block or anything. I got a Kozyx Channeler, 5 generic, add 2 to your mana pool, and it's a 4/4. It has tap, add 2 to your mana pool. Interesting, big-looking creature. I got a McKindy Slide Runner, 1 and a red, Beast Trample. That's a 2/1 landfall. Whenever land enters the battlefield under your control, McKindy Slide Runner gets +1/+1 until end of turn. So if you play a bunch of, crap, I can't remember those cards. Those cards that you tap and sacrifice to put a land on the battlefield, you can get them pretty strong. Or if you just put one out, it'll become a 3/2. The first uncommon is a Resolute Blade Master. I think I've pulled this card before. Looks like he's sitting on some strange, I don't even know, space looking like. 3, a red and a white, Human Soldier Ally. It's a 2/2 and has rally. Whenever Resolute Blade Master or another ally enters the battlefield, creatures you control gain double strike until end of turn. So you're playing an ally deck, double strike is a pretty good thing to have because it deals first strike damage and then regular combat damage. So that's awesome. And if you attack a player, it would give them 4. Because it would attack once, and then regular combat. Very cool. The second uncommon I got is a Processor Assault. 1 and a red. Sorcery. Devoid. This color has no card. Looks like he's slinging rocks at him or something. As an additional cost to cast a Processor Assault, put a card opponent owns from their exile pond to their graveyard. Processor Assault deals 5 damage to target creature. So they need to have an exile pile to have that. And I got a Blighted Fen. Kind of like this card. Might put it in one of my black decks. It just adds colors. I wish it added black to land pool. It is a non-basic land. It has 4 black. Sacrifice Blighted Fen. Target opponent sacrifices a creature. Very cool. So it's a land that let them know on the field that you can play at any time and make them sack a creature. Very fun. Put this in the non-basic land pile. And the rare I got is, of course, another land. Lumbering Falls. Lumbering Falls enters the battlefield tapped. Add green or blue to your mana pool. I don't have a green or blue deck yet. To a green and a blue, Lumbering Falls becomes a 3/3 blue elemental creature with hexproof until end of turn, and it's still a land. Very cool. I always kind of like land creatures. And that's the rare. And no expedition. I got an Eldrazi Sky and token, of course, and an island. And I'm about to open this pack up, but my dead battery's gonna die again, so I'm gonna just charge it for a few minutes and then finish off with the Stero pack. Be right back. Alright, and I'm back for the final recording. And I'm gonna open this Magic the Gathering Theros 15 card booster pack. Hopefully I get something cool. This is interesting. Why is there a tape over the label, over the scanner? I feel like that someone pretended to buy this at like a self-scan and just slid it and it didn't read it. That feels shady to me. I don't know why they would do that. Who knows? Yeah, I don't know. Interesting. But that pulls up a little red flag for me. I don't know why. The first card I got is chosen by Heliod. The sun, the rays upon him are good. Can't really tell. Oh, there's like a huge horse or Pegasus and another horse head, and he's bowing with his long pike. It's one and a white. Enchantment aura. Enchanted creature. When chosen by Heliod, enters the battlefield, draw a card. An enchanted creature gets +0/+2. So it's a card draw, and you get a +2 defense. Throw it in the common. Flesh Mad Steed. Is he eating his own flesh? Or is he like evaporating? I don't even know. Very interesting picture. Would not want to try to ride that. Interesting. I wish it's not. It's just a horse. It's not even like a zombie horse. Just a horse. One in a black. Just a horse. You know. Nice. Go pet it. Whenever another creature dies, tap Flesh Mad Steed and it's a 2/2. Well, it is a 1/2 for a 2/2, but if a creature dies, you gotta tap him, because he's mad. I got a... Wow, this art is interesting. Like a mix of a... It's a take on a seahorse with an actual horse head. I like that a lot. Breaching Hippocamp. Yeah, I like that. I like that. Good art. Good job, artist. 3 and a blue. Horsefish. I wish it said sea horsefish or something. Funny. Yeah, it's flash. You may cast a spell anytime you can cast an instant. So you can just slap him out even when your opponent... it's his turn. When Breaching Hippocampus enters... Hippocamp enters the battlefield. Another target... Untap another target creature you control. It's a 3/2. So you can play him... like maybe when he declared attackers. Then play him for flash. Get untap a big guy. And then block with either him or the big guy. Yeah, so very cool. Looks like I got some equipment. Some bird shoes. Some flying feet. Fleet feather sandals. Two generic artifact equipment. Equipped creature has flying and haste. Not bad. An equipped cost is 2. Attached target creature to creature you can... Attach to target creature you control only as a sorcery. So, you can get it out turn 2, then put it on next turn. Or if you have 4, you can get it out right away. Give him flying in haste. Not too bad. It looks like I got a aqueous form. Escaping the jail by turning into water. Very cool. But I don't know if that's good for the village. 1 blue, enchanted aura. Enchanted creature. Enchanted creature can't be blocked. Whenever enchanted creature attacks, scry 1. Well, I like that. So every time you attack, he can't be blocked, and you get a scry. Very cool. It's just a 1 for an enchantment. I got this one before, Nelia's Presence. I like how they have the cosmos and the stars in the background. I'm really a fan of space. One in a green enchantment aura, enchant land. When Nelia's presence enters the battlefield, draw a card. So it's a draw card, and enchanted land is every basic land type in addition to its others. So very cool. It's a mana card, and you draw a card with it. Very cool. Lovely art. A Titan Strength. I've seen this one. Gain the strength to stop the boulder. Was he rolling up the hill for the world's strongest man contest? Who knows? Titan Strength, one red, instant, target creature gets +3/+1 until end of turn, and scry. Look at the top card of your library, you will put that card on the bottom of your library. So you pretty much get to pick your next draw. If you like the card, put it back on top. If you don't, stick it under, and then you have a chance at something better. I like cards with scry. And it's a red card, and it's not bad. It's an instant. Very cool. Probably getting a kill with that. Traveling Philosophers. Teaching your ways about your gold cup and your scrolls. Very interesting. One and a white creature, human advisors, and it's just a 2/2 creature for 2 mana. Very cool. Stymied Hopes? I'm not sure. That looks like an explosion of ice or something, and it looks like fire in the background. I don't even know. Interesting. One and a blue. Counter target spell unless the controller pays one, and it has a scry one. To me, I would still use counter spell, the original, because they can easily have one leftover mana, but you would also get to scry if they counter it, so you could always just use this as a scry card, I guess, and a try to counter it. So look at the top card of your library. You may put that card in your hand or on the bottom of your library. It's alright, but nothing beats just the simple counter spell. Well, maybe some things, like Force of Will or whatever. But those are expensive. I got a Styre Rambler. He looks like he's got, I forgot what the hell's creatures are called. The legs of like a goat or something. And the body of a human and a big old kukri in his hands. And he's looks like he got some fruit. Looks real good. It has Trample and it's a 2/1. 2/1 creature with trample, so put like throw a Titan Strength on him and get him to do some more damage. Very cool. Jump over the leaves. What is that? Oh, it's a little bit of grass in front. Good art. I got a. What is this guy doing? Styre Piper. He looks like a friend of his. The legs of like a. Not sure, I forget. It is a 2 and a green. Styre Rogue. 3 and a green. Target creature must be blocked this turn if ailing. It's a 2/1. It says target creature, not this one. So if you have a big creature, attack with him, pay that, and then he must be blocked. I feel like he's a little crazy, and I can't tell what he's doing. If he's jumping into the spike pits, or is he trying to like calm everyone? It looks like an explosion in the background. But very cool. That was the first uncommon. Second uncommon is some sort of bull creature that's like behind flames and has the cosmos over him. Very cool. Purephoros's Emissary. 3 and a red enchanted creature ox. It has a bestow of 6 and a red. If you cast this card for its bestow cost, it's an aura spell. And with enchant creature, so you can enchant your creature with it. And it becomes a creature again if it's not attached to a creature. Philosopher's Emissary can't be blocked except by 2 or more creatures, so he has menace. An enchanted creature gets +3/+3 his strength and can't be blocked except by 2 or more creatures and menace. So if you want to, you can play him down by himself for 4, or you can use him as enchantment for 7, and this it would gain +3/+3 and menace, so he'd become a 5/4. Very cool. Like those cards, you can choose. And when this creature would die, he would just flop back out on the battlefield as a creature. Very cool. Vanquish the Foul. Got that one planeswalker. Got like a sword on a pike. Interesting. 5 and a white. Destroy target creature with power 4 or greater and scry 1. It's kind of expensive, but you get a scry, I guess. Look at the top card of your library. You may put that card from the bottom of your library. You may put that card on the bottom of your library. Either put it on top or the bottom. This reminds me of this one card I have. It's like 1 and a 2. It says destroy target creature power 4 or greater, or target creature gets indestructibility until end of turn. I think that's better. And it looks like I got a legendary creature. Very cool. Is he a turtle? He's a hydra. Plakronos World Eater. 2 and 2 green. Legendary creature hydra. Monstrosity is X, so XX in green. If this creature isn't monstrous, put X 1/1 counters on it and becomes monstrous. When Fulcaranos World Eater becomes monstrous, it deals X damage divided as you choose among any number of target creatures your opponent controls. Of those creatures dealt damage equal to the power. Each of those creatures deals damage equal to its power to Plakronos. So when it becomes monstrous, you can damage creatures, but they also do damage to you. But really, the way this double X works is if you have to pay the same in the both. So you put 1/1 in a green, he would come in with a 1/1 counter, and then it would deal 1 damage to each creature. Yeah, it would deal 1 damage to each creature. So he'd really want to try to get like a 4/4 in a green, so it would do 4 damage to each creature, and then deal damage to him, and he'd become a 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. He'd be a 9/9. Very interesting card. He's a Hydra. And I put that in the Mythic pile. And I got an Advertisement and a Plains. One thing to note too is, oh, this one might be on the, no, it's just on different stock. Its tokens are on different stock. I'll sacrifice this land. You can see the Ben test. And then you can see the blue. This is just like white paper, because I accidentally bent a goblin token while I was playing to do the bend test. And it's sadly creased. Alright, so overall, this was a review of this weird Meijer pack. It came with 2 20-sided dice and 4 6-sided dice. 2 packs, Theros and a Battle for Zendikar. Came with an Avacyn Restored deck with this as the main creature, so you could probably figure out what that is. It came with 50, I have 49 now because I ripped one, 50, oop, Ultra Pro sleeve cards with a cool dragon logo, so maybe for a dragon deck, but I wish it came with 60. It came with this storage case, which is alright. If it's by Ultra Pro, I think these things get quite expensive, but I don't think so. It just says, no, it is actually by Ultra Pro, but it says China right above it, and I think these are quite expensive, but I actually don't care for them, because there's not a good way to pick it up. If it's, you have to pick it up at like the very bottom, otherwise there's no like actual seal. I wish there's like little magnets or something, but yeah, and it is acrylic. It's kind of tough, but I'm not sure, like I don't want to bend it too much. I feel like it might shatter. If you drop it, it might shatter. It also came with this really great reference guide. This is definitely the best one I've ever seen. It has like all the abilities up till Avacyn Restored, I believe, and it tells you like how to play better than like this, way better. And it also came with a little color chart to tell you what each color does to help you build a deck from it. Very cool. So, and it also cost $22, $24 I think after tax, so it's quite a bit of money, but I'll let you be the judge. It did come with quite a nice stuff. Some nice sleeves, some nice dice, 2 packs, and Avacyn Restored. I think just like a deck box pack that comes with a booster card, and they just removed the booster and the nice acrylic case. So be up to you as the judge of it. But overall, it's an alright product. I'm not sure if I would buy it again. I think it would be better justified at $15, and maybe if it had one more pack in it. And yeah, that's my overall opinion of this review. I hope it helped you. And yeah, and one last thing, I'm just gonna show you what I've been rendering on lately, this computer. And if you can see, this computer is very old. My mom got it when we were in hard times when we were kids, so it's probably even older than mine. It has 2 gigs of RAM, 120 gigahertz, and AMD Antheon processor, probably just one core. And yeah, so I'm going to be rendering this video on that because I took multiple breaks, so I can't just take it off my camera unless I find a way. And we'll play a little guessing game. How long do you think it took me to render a 15-minute video on that computer I just showed you? That's a good guess, but you should know that I can't hear you, and the correct answer is 8.5 hours. So I hope this video can somehow be combined on my camera and then downloaded off of it. Otherwise, I'll probably be rendering it for probably 24 hours or something. But all in good fun. I hope you guys enjoyed this review/unboxing. And yeah, take it easy.